Ciao, my name is Emilia and... Oh no! It happens again! Ciao, my name is Emilia and I am a young temporary assistant professor at the Università degli Studi Mediterranei di Reggio Calabria. Today I will show you some results of our paper recently published in ACS Sustainable Chemistry Engineering Journal under the program Letters for Emerging Scholar. Do you really want to know what we did in our lab? If so, keep watching this video and pay attention to the incredible story I'm going to tell you.
The protagonists of this story are spent lithium-ion batteries, also known as LIPS, a precious waste that we used as an efficient heterogeneous catalyst for the reactive upgrading of biomass derived furfural. The management, the disposal and the recycling of e-waste are crucial since, if not correctly conducted, they can generate serious problems for the environment and the human health. Lithium-ion batteries are widely present in most electronic devices and already represent an important secondary resource for the recovery of important metals such as cobalt and nickel that are widely known as effective metal center in many catalytic projects aimed to the upgrading of biomass. While furfural is one of the most promising bio-based compounds for the production of several chemicals and materials. The e-waste used is sourced from a recycling facility where the spent lithium-ion batteries are treated by mechanical processing. This material, also known as black mass, was filtered, grinded with a ball mill apparatus, calcined, and then finally reduced at 500 Celsius degree for 6 hours under hydrogen flow. The thermal analysis highlights how the black mass is stable at temperature below 700 Celsius degree. At the same time, the TPR profile is characterized by three main hydrogen consumption peaks that can be related to the reduction respectively of nickel, cobalt and manganese cations. XRD analysis clearly showed that in the black mass, lithium cobalt oxide, lithium nickel oxide and lithium manganese oxide are the main phases present. The oxidation processes lead to a high decrease in the intensity of peaks related to the graphitic carbon as a consequence of its oxidation to carbon oxide. After the reductive treatment, the formation of metallic cobalt nickel was observed. At the same time, ACM images reveal both the presence of metallic cobalt, characterized by round shapes, as well as the persistence of manganese oxide species. The so-obtained cobalt-nickel catalyst was then tested in the conversion of furfural into furfuryl alcohol, a precious building block for the chemical and pharmaceutical industry. Therefore, it's very important to find selective catalysts for the hydrogenation of the carbonyl bond of furfural. Under CTH condition, by using 2-propanol as H donor, a significant conversion of furfural into furfuryl alcohol was achieved after 90 minutes also as temperatures as low as 120 Celsius degree with an overall furfuryl alcohol yield of 70%. While, in the presence of molecular hydrogen as a reducing agent, the hydrogenation of furfural proceeds faster with a complete conversion into furfuryl alcohol after 90 minutes at 120 Celsius degree. As expected, the conversion of furfural increased by increasing the reaction temperature, and it is worth of note that no side products were detected under all reaction conditions adopted. Finally, in order to extend the substrate scope, hydrogenation of other aldehydes and ketones were also tested. The results clearly show that our catalyst can be efficiently used as a heterogeneous system for reductive upgrading of several biomass substrates. Overall, the study opens the route to the use and recycle of spent LIPS for the preparation of catalytic materials suitable for the reductive upgrading of lignocellulosic biomasses. I would like to sincerely thank my colleagues from the Università degli Studi Mediterranei di Reggio Calabria and all partners of the NextLIP project, including the NSTM, Università di Brescia and Sverim, for their precious support.
So, I hope that you enjoy my story and I would like to send you my regards from our lab. Ciao!